The Italian Grand Prix is underway. A long run, of course, to turn one, but it was a very good start with the lights out from Tatsuki Suzuki, but immediately into the slipstream comes Pedro Acosta. Good start also from Rodrigo, who leads, but he's on the outside line. Surely Acosta, with that inside line, has the advantage. He does. He will lead into turn one.
Strong start by Fenati as well. He was briefly up into fourth from that third row in seventh place. He's around fifth place now, trying to find a way up on the inside of Foggia. Was there a faller at the back of the pack there going into the first corner, San Donato?
Sarah, who is that that's gone down? It's one of the
big crashes
here. Oh. Huge crashes, and there's a bike heading down. Now that is Carlos Tatai. Who else has gone down? Is that Migno? And that is Denis Anjou, and he's holding his left hand.
Well, Anjou went first, didn't he? Down through Casanova and Savelli. And then there was a separate instance behind involving three riders.
It is Migno. There is Koffler as well as Carlos Tatai. So, barrel rolling through the gravel trap there. Hopefully everyone's okay. Migno then, one of the favourites for today's race, as well as Denis Anjou. And there's a few riders here that are hurt.
Yeah, that was a big, big one for Andrea Migno. He went barrel rolling three, four times through the gravel trap. Koffler at the moment unable to get up from the scene. Back at the front, world championship leader Pedro Acosta in his that has the advantage into Bacini for the first time. Can anybody get the slipstream behind him? He's got six, seven bike lengths back to Gabriel Rodrigo in second spot. Excellent first lap by Fenati. Started seventh. He's going to come over the line inside that top three.
Well, this will give you a good example of what slipstream can be like in Moto3. Can anyone close down, what was it, a seven or eight bike length lead for Acosta over the line? Here comes Denis Foggia, though. The Rocket, as he's known, flies through to take the lead here in Italy into turn one.
So Migno, Anjou, Tatai and Koffler were the four men caught up in that incident at turn seven. And it sort of broke up the pack a little bit early on. So Acosta then been relegated back to third with that slipstream effect. It's Foggia that now leads his home Grand Prix.
Fenati then on the tower. Look at Fenati. He's going to have a look up the inside. That was geared up a couple of laps ago because Foggia was just a bit too tight going into Casanova.
You've got to back yourself to make a move down the hill. Lowest part of the circuit into Arrabbiata 1. Fenati's done thousands and thousands of kilometres around this Mugello circuit, using all of his experience there to make that switch on the Foggia. Foggia's strategy crystal clear. As soon as he's got the bike upright and ready to accelerate up to top gear, he just moves immediately to the left-hand side of the circuit, trying to break the slipstream. Good exchange of overtakes this at the start of lap six between the two Italians, Foggia and Fenati.
Yeah, this is as good as we've seen Foggia since Portugal, of course. Really, really good effort here. You know, when Foggia's got the speed, it normally means he's going to be podium bound.
Yeah, when you look at his recent record, as you mentioned, Steve, it's only 2 points finishes in the last nine have been second places in Portimao at the back end of 2020 and at the start of 2021.
Rodrigo at the moment, though, going up the inside of him on his Gresini Honda number two. Acosta again opting for the outside line, and he does them all around the outside to lead into turn one. Excellent stuff from the championship leader.
Breaking on the kerb on the outside of San Donato. That's braving the extreme from Pedro Acosta, and he finds himself back at the front of this Italian Grand Prix. It's getting closer and closer between the lead men. 1.7 seconds now, covering the top 15 over the line.
Tatsuki Suzuki so far, so good for him. He's in fourth, he's well placed. Acosta then it is that has the advantage. Rodrigo also overdue a big result in Moto3. It's been a long time now since that podium a few years ago.
Yeah, he's due one, like you say, Steve. Only two top six finishes in the last 13 Grand Prix. It'll be a big boost, almost like a home Grand Prix for him, isn't it? What a move that is by Foggia, though. That's brilliant. That's awesome. Down in Arrabbiata 1, up the inside of Acosta. Nothing the Spanish teenager could do about that. Arrabbiata 2 now. Suzuki fires up the inside of Rodrigo.
Suzuki also, yeah, looking pretty good, isn't he? That was a nice move. Narizumi Sasaki is creeping closer now to this group. He's just moved up into the top six. Adrian Fernandez there, just trying to give a little boost to... Well, Raul Fernandez giving a boost to Adrian.
Suzuki then now has picked up the baton and runs at the front of this Italian Grand Prix. Over the crest, down the hill in the braking zone for Corentaio. Foggia second from Fenati. Then it is Sergio Garcia. He's got Rodrigo immediately behind him.
Our opening race winner of the season, Jaume Massia there, number five, has just started to make some progress now as well. He's fighting his way through and up into the top eight. Dive bomb. Darren looked like he was ready to make a move there into turn one. Look at all of this drama going on. There is Darren Binder as we head into turn one. Absolutely no idea who's leading this race after all of these exchanges, as Rodrigo there just forces himself underneath Jaume Massia.
That was lovely by Rodrigo. Got up the inside of Binder and Massia. What a time to ride on board there with Sasaki. Lovely shot. Just the room available for Rodrigo to nip the space, and he took it quite brilliantly. Two spots in, one at San Donato.
And after all of those exchanges, the riders that went across the line, seventh and eighth, are first and second. Yumi Sasaki then challenging now Gabriel Rodrigo for third, on board with Acosta, heading down Casanova, now flicking it left through Savelli. Suzuki looked close to dropping out of the top five. He's made a desperate lunge, but he's wide there into 15. He will be able to cut back, actually. And he does. That actually's not worked out too badly for him at all, has it? Look at the drive he got by going deep into the final turn.
Yeah, the master plan right now for Suzuki is working to perfection, but he could get swallowed up here. The field, concertina up as they crest at 250 kilometres an hour. Somebody was grass tracking there. They're what, six, seven, eight, nine abreast into San Donato. Close your eyes and hope you can stop it. Oh, Binder aggressive up the inside of Toba. Picked up the Japanese man into the first corner. Binder reclaims a podium spot, although be it briefly, because Fanati sweeps on through, not just a third, but a second as well.
Binder from nowhere, up into fourth as well. Great late-breaking move from the Petronas Sprinter Honda rider.
So it's Foggia then that leads then from Fanati into turns two and three for the final time. Gabriel Rodrigo, desperate for a return to the podium. He's in third place right now.
Acosta made up another place. He's through on John McPhee. He's into seventh. Surely he can't win it from here.
Into the second sector, and it's still Foggia. They come towards the breathtaking Casanova Savelli section. No way through right now for Fanati. He's under real pressure here from Rodrigo, and Rodrigo's got the inside line down into Savelli. Rodrigo pinches second place from the Italian.
Gabriel Rodrigo is so desperate for a podium here. Oh. Likewise, Massia. Sasaki's not been on the podium since Aragon last year. They're going to have a job on here to try and chase down Dennis Foggia.
Yeah, Massia squeezed Fanati out wide as well on that little spurt of acceleration between Arrabbiata 1 and 2. Foggia, bit of daylight between himself. Massia attacks Rodrigo down the hill into turn 10. He's made it through. Stunning late charge from Massia in Mugello. Has he done enough to get on par potentially with Foggia?
No one looks like they've got anything for Dennis Foggia. Sasaki up the inside there of Gabriel Rodrigo through Corentaio. Can anyone do anything about this speed from the Leopard Honda out front?
Of course, some serious movement there from Sasaki's Dunlop front tyre. He somehow managed to pull it up on the brakes. Foggia looking brilliant through Biondetti 1 and 2. And if you haven't got a slipstream on the Italian, it's going to be very, very difficult. They all try and find some time on the brakes. Into Vicini for the final time. And it always, as it does in Mugello, comes down to the slipstream showdown. It's fantastic, Foggia. Can it be a win in Mugello? It's from Massia, Rodrigo and Sasaki.
Here we go, the checkered flags out in Moto3. Is this one Foggia's? Massia desperately trying to lunge out of the slipstream, but I don't think he's got enough. Foggia wins in Italy, just from Jaume Massia, and Rodrigo is back on the podium.
But it's a famous win for Foggia here in Mugello, the 20-year-old Italian, second win, seventh career podium. It's Foggia, formidable in the Tuscany Mountains.